Hi, my name is Robert Feranek. I'm from FEDEVEL Academy. And in this video, we are going to speak about filters, queries, and rules. Or to be specific about the queries used inside some rules, what you can maybe find useful or what you may want to use in your projects. I'm creating this video because many people ask me how to create these equations or how to create these queries for filters. And there is actually like a very simple and very elegant way how you can create these queries. And that's what I would like to show you in this video. And when we are speaking about the filters, we will have a look also at the other ways how you can create these equations. I'm going to show you how you can find more information about the commands which are used in these equations. I would like to mention also wildcards, so how you can simply apply these queries on a bunch of nodes or components in your design. And I would like to go through some of the rules what we use in our boards, some of the most common rules, and we are going to have a look at these queries inside of these rules. So if you need to set these kind of rules in your board, you can very simply like get some kind of inspiration what kind of queries you may want to use there. Okay, that's what I would like to speak about in this video, and let's do it. Let's start. In our very first example, we are going to highlight the unconnected pins of this processor. Now, what kind of filter you would use if you would like to highlight only the unconnected parts of this processor? What would you write here into this filter? Very simple way how you can find out what kind of equation, what kind of query you need to use in this filter to highlight these unconnected pins is not start writing here, but use find similar objects instead. Zoom in. If you'd like to work with paths, so right click on this path and use this find similar objects. And when you use this, there is this magic checkbox down here. Can you see it? Create expression. And this is how we are going to create it here. So we are going to build the filter in this window, and then we will simply create the expression. So don't forget, you need to check this. Then when we press apply, the expression will appear here. Leave this as I have it here. So check this, not check, check, check. We would like to just highlight the unconnected pin. So set here dim, everything else will be dimmed. And because we are going to work with paths, leave this same. And what else we need to set here, do you know? We would like to see all the unconnected paths. So they are basically connected to no net. Okay, so we would like to highlight all the paths with no net. So I'm going to set this to same. And you can press apply or you can press OK and watch here what is going to happen. Yes! See? The expression was automatically built. And when I zoom in, all the unconnected paths are highlighted or everything else is dim. If we would like to only highlight these connected pins, what you can do, you can directly edit this here, or if you are not sure how to edit this equation, you can do it this way. Right click, use find similar objects again, and instead of looking for paths which are connected to no net, we are going to look for all the paths which are connected to something different than no net. And again, when you use this create expression, press apply, watch what is going to happen here, okay? What is going to change? See, now we are looking for all the nets which are different from no net. And all the connected paths are now highlighted. Next example. We need to adjust the width of these tracks on layer 3 and layer 10. Because we have finished our design and now we would like to use recommended track width to meet the 50 or 55 ohm impedance. And for this layer 3 and layer 10, instead of using the width 0.1 millimeter, the width should be, based on PC manufacturer, the width should be 0.08 millimeter. So we need to change all the tracks with 0.1 millimeter on layer 3 and layer 10 to 0.08 millimeter. How can we do it? Again, we can use find the similar objects to build the initial query, and then we will just adjust the query manually. Right click on a track, find similar objects. We would like to work with tracks, or we would like to select all the tracks which are on layer 3. So I'm going to put here same, and with the width 0.1 millimeter. So I'm going to put here same. Okay, watch what is going to happen here. This is the equation what we need. We are going to make one adjustment. We would like to work with the tracks not only on layer 3 but also on layer 10. So I'm going to adjust this equation. I'm going to copy this. I'm going to put here or layer 10. I will put this into brackets, and we would like to select all the objects which will meet this filter. We would like to select them. We don't want to zoom. We can mask everything else and deselect non-matching. Apply to all. Now, all the tracks, 0.1 millimeter tracks on layer 3 and also on layer 10 are selected. We can simply go into properties panel and change the width to 0.08, enter. Perfect. In this third example, we are going to create a filter which is going to help us to find incorrectly rotated text on top and bottom overlay layer. Yeah, usually when I create boards, usually I place text on top and bottom overlay layer the way that when you are holding or when someone is holding the PCB, they can read all the text in two directions, maybe like this and like this. Okay, so we would like to check if all the text is rotated correctly. What do we need to do to create this filter? First, we would like to know what is the correct rotation. This is the correct rotation. When I click on this text, it says 0 degrees, and this is also the correct rotation. This is the 90 degrees. And now what? I'm going to start writing the filter here. But I have no idea what to put there. Right click on text, and we are going to use again this magic feature, find similar objects, and this is going to help us to create some basic filter which we will adjust. So what kind of information we need to include in the filter? The object. So we are looking for all the text this has to be set same. We are looking for all the text which is on top overlay or bottom overlay layer. So we would like to put there also this information, and then we need to adjust this because this is only for top overlay, but we would like to also look on bottom overlay. And what else? We would like to also include the information about the rotation. So I'm going to put here same, or maybe different, different, okay? For all the rotation, which is different from 0 degrees, okay? Now, this is the basic filter. This is not what we need, but we can adjust this. How we are going to adjust this? What do we need to change? We are going to look for all the text which is on top overlay or bottom overlay layer. So I'm going to put here or, and I'm going to change this to bottom overlay. Don't forget the brackets. And we are looking for all the text which is on top overlay or bottom overlay layer, and the rotation is different from 0 and 90 degrees. Let's have a look what will happen. Apply to all. Okay, on top overlay everything seems to be fine, but there is something on bottom overlay. This. So this is the text with wrong rotation. This is the text what we need to adjust. I'm going to change this to 90. I'm going to unmask everything. Let's have a look on the bottom layer. And this looks perfect. Yes. Let's go back to this previous board, and we are going to speak a little bit more about these commands which are here. Especially if you would like to write these commands all by yourself, you need to know what kind of commands you can use and how you need to use them. What is the format of these commands? First, I would like to say very often you can use multiple different commands to achieve one thing. So you have more options how to achieve something what you need. For example, this is one of the ways how we can look for all the tracks on layer 1. When I press apply, this will select all the tracks on layer 1. Different way how you can do it is use different command. I'm going to clear this. So, for example, instead of this object kind track, you can use is track. Now, when you start writing, Altium will suggest all the kind of commands what you can use. And you can then select from the list the one what you need. In this case, we need is track, so I'm going to select this. But I still don't know what this command is doing. If you would like to know more information about this, left click on the command and press F1 on your keyboard. This will open help, Altium's help, and here you can read more information about the command and also examples how to use it. So if we would like to use isTrack, we can just write isTrack, or we can use isTrack equals true, or if we don't want to work with tracks, then you can use not isTrack or isTrack equals false. We can use this. This is fine for our filter. So isTrack. If you try this filter, it is going to do exactly same as it was doing before. It will select all the tracks on layer 1. Another way to write this is use, for example, on layer. Start writing on layer. Okay. So is track and is on layer. Now we would like to know how to use this on layer. So left click on the command, press F1 to open help. And to use on layer, we need to use brackets and write inside the layer name. I'm going to put it here, brackets and L1. When we apply this filter, what is going to happen? All the tracks on layer 1 are going to be selected. Now, be careful. With some commands, you can do some things. For example, if you would like to select all the tracks on layer 1, layer 10, layer 11, and layer 12, there is a very simple way how you can do it. Notice all these layers are starting with L1, and then there is like nothing or 0 or 1 or 2. So what you can do, you can use something what is called wildcard. So you would write something like this, L1 star, and this kind of command should or supposed to select all the tracks on layer 1, on layer 10, on layer 11, and on layer 12, because there is this star. So after L1, there can be anything, and all these layers will be considered in the filter. However, this is not going to work. I'm going to clear this, press apply, and you will see this is not going to work because you cannot use wildcard in this kind of command. To use wildcard, we need to go back to simple layer command. So I'm going to write layer like this. We would like to see the format, how to use layer, so press F1. And layer equals or layer is different from. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put here layer equals L1. We are going to try this. Oops. Don't forget to use brackets like this. And okay, this is working. So it's track and it selected everything, all the tracks on layer 1. However, again, this is sometimes tricky. Now you may think like, let's put here the star and it's going to work. It's not. Have a look. If you would like to use wildcard, you need to use, instead of equals, you need to use like. Okay, this. And this is going to work. What this is going to do? This is going to select all the tracks on all the layers which are starting with L1. So this is going to select all the tracks on layer 1, 10, 11, and 12. Have a look. Okay, you can see these are the red tracks selected on layer 1. On layer 2, there is nothing. Layer 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. There are all these tracks. 11, there are no tracks on 11. And you can see the blue tracks selected on the layer 12. So what I wanted to say with this is use F1 to get more information about these commands. Be aware you can use different commands to achieve same thing, but some of the commands may provide you with more options, more possibilities. For example, some of the options can give you possibility to use wildcards. Now, we know how to use these commands. We know how to find information about these commands. But how do I know what kind of commands I can use in this filter. A very simple way where you can kind of find all the commands and properties what you can use in this filter is use this helper. I don't really use this much, but I'm going to show you what you can find there. So click on helper, and all these commands and properties, they are sorted in different kind of categories to make it easier to find them. So if you would like to create this kind of filter, like we are looking for all the tracks on layer one, how we would use this query helper? In the categories, object type checks, we would search for the command which is going to look for the tracks. So we would find here the isTrack command. See, it is here. So here is our command, what we would like to use. And this layer command, you can find it here in the fields. So click here. Here are all the different kind of fields what you can use in this filter. And one of them will be the layer. That's too far. Here is the layer. See, you can find here this property or this command in this list. Same as before, if you would like to know more about the specific command, you can simply just use it. For example, double click, then left click, press F1, and Altium help will open, and it will describe what it is doing, what it is doing and how you can use it. But as I said, I don't really use this much. There is more simple way how you can build your filters. And what I very often use is this builder. Left click here. And have a look how easy it is. So we would like to select all the tracks on layer one. This is how you build it here. Left click. It is object kind is track. And watch here, this building query, it automatically found we would like to use this isTrack command, and this track exists on layer one. Yeah, very simply and very quickly we created the filter isTrack and on layer one. That's why I very often use this building query, because it's very simple to use. And when we are speaking about filters, I would like to mention something like really, really important about using filters in schematic. When you are using filters in schematic, you need to be aware if you are working with current document, open documents, or whole project. Why? Sometimes may happen that you may forget that you, for example, selected all the components in whole project. And then if you apply any change on this selected components in properties panel, it is going to apply in whole project. Have a look. I'm going to show you what I mean. Let's say we would like to select this zero ohm resistor. Right click, find similar. Same in whole project. Okay. So if you make any change here in this properties panel, I'm going to change this 0 ohm to 10 ohms. This change is going to be applied in whole project. If I go on different page, let's say here, all 0 ohm resistors were changed to 10 ohm. That's not what I wanted. Or maybe, sometimes it is, sometimes not. I've seen this couple of times when I was working in Altium and I completely forgot I have something selected on different pages. There used to be these buttons up here, I don't know where they are now, where you could check if you are working with a whole project or only with current page. But if you are not aware what everything is selected in your schematic, by accident you can rename or change something also on the pages where you didn't want to change it. That's what I wanted to say in this short introduction in using filters in schematic. You always need to be aware what everything is selected. So always watch down here. Can you see my cursor? Watch down here how many objects you have selected in what or how many documents. This is going to help you to understand that if you are going to change something in this properties panel, where everywhere these changes are going to be applied. Very, very dangerous sometimes. That's why I wanted to mention this. Let's go back to our board and we are going to have a look at the queries what I use in some of the rules which I often use in my designs. And first two rules what we are going to have a look at are going to specify special clearance between polygon and other objects on this layer. What do you think? Why we would like to specify like special clearance here on this layer? Because we would like to improve this polygon, especially this place which is here. The copper here is not flowing between the vias, and basically in this space here we are creating, at this moment, we are creating like huge hole. And we really don't want to have this huge hole here. We would like to have this copper nicely flowing between the vias. At this moment, here are these spaces. And when you think about this, when PCB is manufactured, these parts which are here, they will be removed anyway. These unconnected parts, they are removed anyway. So here will be like empty space. We can very safely make this clearance a little bit smaller. At this moment, this clearance, this is the standard clearance. When I measure it, you can see the clearance between this via and this polygon, clearance between via and polygon is 0.1 millimeter. If I measure clearance here between this micro via and this polygon, it is 0.1 millimeter. And we would like to make it smaller. Go to design, rules, and these are the two rules what we need to apply. Let's have a look at this one first. I'm going to open it. What is here? In this rule, we are saying that we would like to apply 0.085 millimeter clearance between polygon on layer 2 and layer 11 and any other objects. And notice this, this is very, very important, is region. When I remember when I was trying to figure out how to create this query for very, very first time, I tried the is poly, is polygon, all these kind of things, nothing worked. You have to use is region when you would like to create a rule for polygon. You cannot use is poly or is polygon, that's not going to work. So very important, okay, is region. Again, this rule is creating 0.085 clearance for polygon on layer 2 and layer 11 and between all the other objects. This second rule is very similar. It is creating a special clearance, 0.075 between polygon on layer 2 and layer 11 and all the vias with hole size different from 0.1 millimeter. And the only vias with 0.1 millimeter hole size are the micro vias. So basically, this rule is saying that applies 0.075 clearance between polygon on layer 2 and layer 11 and all the through hole vias. We are going to enable these rules. Press OK. And we need to refresh the or rebuild the polygons. And we are going to have a look what is going to change. I'm going to cancel this. Right click, polygon action, report all, and watch these spaces here. See, this is exactly what we would like to have. Now the copper is nicely flowing between the vias. And it is very nice also here. If we measure the clearance between this micro via and this polygon, what is going to be the clearance? 0.085. If we measure clearance between this through hole via and this polygon, what is going to be the clearance? 0.075. That's exactly what we wanted. The next rule, what we are going to talk about, is again a clearance rule, this time on layer 5, 6, 7, 8. And this rule is going to specify special clearance between polygons. When you have a power layer, something like this, with many polygons, power polygons, you may want to use bigger clearance, bigger distance between these polygons than the standard clearance. So instead of using 0.1 millimeter, we would like to use something bigger. There are more reasons why you would like to use a bigger gap between polygons. One of the reasons is, for example, when they are manufacturing PCB and when they are manufacturing this kind of layer, it is quite hard to remove the copper from very thin places between polygons. It is much better if this gap is a little bit wider. It is much better for PCB manufacturing. Go to design, rules, and this is the rule, polygon to polygon, and this is the query. So nothing really special. This rule is setting 0.2 millimeter clearance between all the polygons on layer 5, 6, 7, and 8, and all the other polygons. There is one more clearance rule what I would like to talk about. And this rule will specify special clearance between non-plated holes and other objects. Non-plated holes are the holes with no copper inside, okay? And usually there is no path around these non-plated holes. And PCB manufacturer, they usually specify minimum clearance between, for example, hole to track. And this clearance is usually bigger than standard minimum clearance. At this moment, if you have a look here, and when I measure the clearance between this non-plated hole and this track, it says it is 0.1 millimeter. This is the standard clearance. But we would like to use 0.2 instead. Go to design, rules, and the rule itself is nothing really special. You can see it here, but there is a small trick. So in this rule, we are setting up 0.2 millimeter clearance between all objects and, this is the trick, in path class non-plated through hole. What does it mean? What do we need to do? we need to create PAD class called NPTH, and we need to include in this PAD class these non-plated holes. And then when this rule is applied, we should be able to route this track around this non-plated hole automatically at distance 0.2 millimeter. So let's do it. The rule is set, only what we need to do is create this PAD class. We are going to double check what is the or where these non-plated holes are located. I know they are inside of this connector J1 and J2 connector, and the path number is 66 and 65. Remember this. Now go to design, classes. We are going to create, do you remember? Path class, right click, add class, call it non-plated through holes, enter. And we need to add here J1 path 65, 66, and J2 path 65, 66. So now we are creating path class with these non-plated holes. Okay, when I go on layer 10 and when we try to route this again, what should happen? This minimum clearance should be 0.2 millimeter. So I'm going to route it. See? Nice. If we measure this, it is 0.2 millimeter. Great. The next rules, what I would like to talk about, will specify minimum track width for powers. Go to design, rules, and these are the rules. For ground, it is very simple. I just specified this rule for all the objects with net ground, and we would like to use minimum track width than 0.2 millimeter. For power, it is a little bit more tricky. And what you can do, you can name all the power nets here and set the minimum width for all of them. Or in our case, all the powers, they are starting with plus sign. So what we can do instead of naming each individual net? We can use the wild card. So how this would look if we make it more simple? Something like this. Okay? So this rule is saying that all the nets starting with plus needs to have minimum track width 0.2 millimeter. We are going to move to a different board, and we are going to speak about this thermal relief. If you have a ground plane on your board, then you may want to specify different rules how to connect different objects to this ground plane. For example, very often what I do, I connect all the vias directly to ground plane, but I don't want to connect the through-hole pins directly. All the through-hole pins which are connected to ground, I usually would like to connect through this thermal relief, because it can be quite hard to solder these kind of pins if they are connected directly. However, for mounting holes, I would like to use the direct connection. And this is how you can specify the rules. Here are the examples. So this one is simple, okay? For all the objects, by default, I would like to use direct connection. But if we are connecting paths, which are connected to ground, then we would like to use thermal relief. But for all the mounting holes, I would like to use direct connection. It is very important how you order these rules, okay? You need to be aware about this priority. If the priority is not set correctly, then you may get different results. The rules may not work as you would expect. The last rule, what I would like to mention in this video, is about component collision. Sometimes happen that you would like to place two components on top of each other. For example, some components may share some parts. I very often use this. Or you may have like 3D models in conflict. Sometimes you would like to place card into a socket. That's what you can see here. And you need to create a rule which will ignore this collision between card and this connector. Okay, it's very simple to do, but I wanted to include it in this video because it's very often used. So this specific example, what we can see here, the card and these two slots or two connectors have the exception in the rules, which looks like this. First object is the card, and the second object is J15 connector or J16 connector, and then ignore the clearance. Clearance is set to zero. And that's everything for this video, where I wanted to speak about filters and queries and rules. I would like to tell you that please leave comments. You may be surprised how useful your comments are. Just the other day or the other week when I posted a video about how to check footprints, number of comments they suggested to use transparent foil. What a great idea. So when you leave comments, I learn a lot, and many other people who are reading the comments, they may learn a lot. So if you have any tips about some special queries or filters, what you often use, leave it in the comments. You can help, or you may help many people. I would like to thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to press like button. Also, if you would like to see all the future videos, don't forget to subscribe. And that's everything for today. Thank you very much again, and see you next time. Bye.